So here's Sardinia, another region. All right, we did Sicily, we did Puglia, now we're in Sardinia. This is the wine map of Sardinia. We're going to go right over here in a little valley called Valle di Odoene. Now, Odoene is not even an Italian word, but it means valley of something. I had to look it up. You know, I speak fluent Italian. I said, what the hell does Odoene mean? No idea. I had to look it up. So in Sardinia, they have these ancient languages. Of course, they speak Italian. It's part of Italy now, but there's a history there of 8,000 years. There was an ancient civilization called the Nuragic people. It goes way, way back. And this word probably came at some point or another from that. What it means is God, Valley of God. Why do they call it the Valley of God? This particular little valley is some of the most fertile territory on the island. And I can only find one producer that has a vineyard on top of this soil. And you're going to taste that wine today. You're going to be tasting a grape called Canonau. Anyone want to try to say that? Canonau. Okay. This is a red grape that is dominant in Sardinia. Now, when you talk to other wine people, they'll tell you it's similar to Grenache from France or Garnacha in Spain. I don't personally believe that. The latest news is that they did some excavations in Sardinia and found carbon grape seeds that were cut on out, making Sardinia probably the oldest wine culture in the Mediterranean. So this grape is arguably 3,000 years old. It's been there for a long time, and it's 100%. And this is the smallest batch wine that you're gonna taste tonight. The Ataruya winery produces only 7,000 bottles of this wine by hand. This is a phenomenal wine. Extremely low yields. They don't grow a lot of grapes. It's very concentrated, it's very powerful. Let's pick it up. Should have a powerful aroma. Think red fruits. There's gonna be some mystery there. There's gonna be maybe some rosemary. There's gonna be these, it's called le macchie, which are Mediterranean trees, herbs. Go for a sip. Massive, right? It gave even more on the back palate, right? Explosive. Persistent finish, it keeps going. Long, persistent finish.
Tasting in your nose.
It's
right?
Powerful.
Very,
it's
what's
powerful.
What's the alcohol on this?
15%. This is a powerhouse. This is great with pork. Now, one of the specialty dishes in Sardinia is suckling pig. All right, great pairing. Think ribeye steak, fatty meats. Great pairings for this. Roasted meats, lamb. Anyone want to guess how much this wine costs?
Retail.
50 bucks?
30.
30? 45. 80? Mm-hmm. Now, in America, how much would it cost retail?
$25.
25? Who said 25? Okay. You're hoping. Do you like it?
It is good.
You love it?
Yes.
It's growing on you.
It's growing on you. I like what the cheese did.
So I heard everything from 25 to 80. Anyone think it's more than $80? All right, I heard from 25 to 80. Well, it's small.
That's boutique-y.
Right? All right. You can taste the quality, though, besides that. All right. It's retailing around $25.
Yeah.
Okay. And the reason why it's $25 is because of me. So I'm trying to make a contribution to the people who care.
We really
appreciate it. Yeah. And not thank you. The fact of the matter is not everyone cares, but you guys are here at this Italian wine and cheese class, so clearly you guys care. But a lot of people, they'll walk right past this bottle not knowing that it's an $80 bottle that costs $25. This wine will beat some of the Barolos that I've tasted recently.